Good morning and welcome back to Galashiels for another border station walk. Today we're on walk number 8 from Galashiels. Fishing pools and bluebells, and I don't think there's much chance of us seeing any bluebells today as it's the 1st of April. But hopefully there might be some other things for us to see out there. We're walking a circular route alongside Gala Water initially, then it should be a lovely walk by the Tweed, and finally coming back over the Southern Upland Way over Gala Hill. The route today is the first of one of the longer ones from Galashiels, so we've got about 15 and a half kilometres to go, which will work out around 10 miles or so. And it's should be a cracker. We're down by the Gala Water, then we'll be walking up the Tweed and following the Southern Upland Way back across Gala Hill into the town itself. So unfortunately the weather this morning isn't the best. It's a bit drizzly, although it is supposed to clear up a little in the afternoon, so I get the feeling it's going to be on and off. It seems to be the one constant in the borders that wherever you go, you can see the Eildon Hills. They're just such an iconic landmark for this part of the world. A lot of the walks so far, we've had views over the Gala Water, and I think the first couple of walks at Stow, we walked alongside for a bit, but we're going to be following it here and to the end, to the point at which it joins the Tweed. So it's quite nice to have that sort of continuity in a way. And then this whole part is sort of old industrial land, it's industrial estates. There's an old mill back there, which is now part of Edinburgh University, I think, Textile School, which is really what Gala was famous for. Looks like an old railway bridge, they must have realigned it here. River's well up at the moment, but it's absolutely serene. Just love walking alongside rivers like this. It'll be even better once we reach the Tweed. See the gas works there, and reaching the road here, I think we're going to be turning right alongside the Tweed, and we'll be picking up the Southern Upland Way for a short distance, and we're maybe only about a mile away from Tweed Bank Station. We're getting into the good part of the borders. There we go, we're on the Southern Upland Way, so we'll just drop down to the river and follow that. And when I did the Southern Upland Way a couple of years ago, this was probably the ugliest part of it, just getting from here through to Tweed Bank. The only place on the route really that you went through an industrial landscape. We're changing the route slightly here. The book has us going along the road to a roundabout and then down under a bridge before coming down onto this. But I think rather than do that, we've got the opportunity to walk along the riverside here. It's a bit muddy at the moment, but we'll follow the Southern Upland Way. And the two routes will join up because we're just going to follow the Tweed to Yare Bridge, where we'll pick up the Southern Upland Way again on the opposite side of Gala. And this is very pleasant at the moment, apart from the mud. And we should get some cracking views of Abbotsford as well, the home of Walter Scott, which is on the other side of the river. Here, ground is just covered in wild garlic, and give it another couple of weeks and this will be spectacular when they're out in full flower. It's just such a wonderful time of year, spring, when you get that feeling that everything's about to burst into life. Risen up to meet the road that we've been on, and if I swing round, hopefully you should just be able to see through the trees. That's Abbotsford, and the place is well worth a visit. There's quite a collection there. What sort of stuff? It's artworks and things.
It's all Walter
Scott's Walter collections.
Related to Walter Scott.
And I think it's open all year. Is it National Trust for Scotland that's run by?
No, I don't think it
is. Or Hysteric Scotland? I think it must. It must be the National Trust.
Or
is it private?
I'm not sure, Aaron.
I'd need to have a look. I'll pop it up on screen. Definitely worth a visit. Especially if you're interested in literature and a Walter Scott, and everything in this area has kind of got a Walter Scott connection. You've got the Waverley route. There is a Walter Scott Way, I think, which incorporates part of the Southern Upland Way. I seem to remember whether it's waymarked or not. I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's some place, isn't it?
It is. It's here we're going to leave the Southern Upland Way for the moment. And we're going to carry on down this road. And we've probably got about 4 miles by the river. And we pick up the Southern Upland Way again at Yare Bridge. But I just love the Tweed Valley. It is so, so nice an area here, and the whole area around the Tweed is just absolutely delectable, even on a sort of dull grey day like this.
I think this has to be one of the most random items I've come across on a walk, just in the middle of nowhere, is a water fountain. Let's have a look. I'm not holding my breath. No. Last time I saw one of these was when I was at school, actually. Just, yeah, completely bizarre. It's here, by the side of the road and in this patch of ground. So, your guess is as good as mine. We're sticking to the higher route here, which is part of the cycle network, but there is the option to stick down by the river. We'll be back with the river relatively shortly once we cross the main road, which you can maybe hear just up to our right. Oh. Let's take this first. Cheers.
Come on, dear.
Where was I? Yeah, we'll cross the A7 by the old bridge. I think it is it your bridge? Oh yeah. Morning. But it's quite muddy down by the river at the moment, so certainly you do have the two options to stick by the river. It suddenly turned into rush hour. Cheers. Yeah, cyclists here, there and everywhere, so you can definitely tell that it's a cycle path. Where was I? Yeah. So the two routes converge at the bridge over the Tweed. There's a new bridge. The two routes converge at the old Tweed Bridge, which has been renovated and shut to traffic sort of relatively recently. We won't cross, but we'll stay on this side of the river. So this is where the Riverside route rejoins this. And to be honest, I'd much prefer to walk down by the river than the tarmac. But when the weather's like this, it is a bit easier to walk on the tarmac. That fantastic old bridge. No, we carry on down. And it's amazing to think that this old bridge carried the main A7 south. We'll just walk onto it and have a look. I'm not sure when it was bypassed by the new bridge. It looks like maybe the 70s or the mid 80s. So 2017 it was refurbished, but look at that, Tweed Valley.
Absolutely wonderful construction.
Now we've come past the old Tweed Bridge there, which is just a fabulous old structure, really made to be aesthetically pleasing. We're down on the, really, the fisherman's track by the Tweed, and we're going to stay with this until... Wow! Are those sand martins? They are incredibly early. This is the 1st of April today, and we've got sand martins. That's fantastic. Anyway, where was I? Yeah, we've maybe got about 3 or 4 kilometres by the side of the river, off tarmac, thankfully. So, I just love the walking by the river here. It's such a beautiful area, and the hills surrounding it. This is about as good walking that you get in the Borders. Rain's come on again, but gives the hills so much atmosphere. So shrouded in the mist. I'm still made up that there's sand martins so early in the year. I wouldn't have expected them for quite some time yet, so really early arrivers. One of the little fishermen's huts that dot the riverbank, both sides actually, along here. Really is just gorgeous down here. The river is absolutely serene, just flowing past. And it's a salmon fishery as well. So when the season's in full swing, you'll see a lot of fly fishermen about. What's surprising is how small a footprint the river actually has here. And it's the floodplain is remarkably small. I would have expected it to sort of be, especially with the sort of ground that's here, to be a lot wider, but it does make it such a beautiful area. Come to the Scottish Borders, it's great. Just while we're down by the river, I seem to remember a couple of years ago seeing, it was either an article or some talk somewhere about a long distance route along the Tweed. And quite honestly, I'd love to see that happen. It would be a fabulous, fabulous route. I think the majority of the river has access. Certainly there's footpath all the way between Galashiels and, well, Melrose really, to Peebles certainly and beyond. There might be places where it would need to come off route, but a source to sea route from Berwick would just be, I think, one of the best trails in the country. Whether it happens or not, well, we'll have to wait and see. It's probably a good few years off yet, considering I think the West Highland Way was first mooted in the 1960s. So it took them until 1981 to open it. So it just shows you how long the process takes in establishing new long distance routes. But there have been plenty of long distance routes pop up in the meantime. So watch this space. But certainly if it happens, I'll be looking at trying to walk it at some time in the future. We're here at Yare Bridge now. I'm not sure of the age, I'll need to have a look at it, but it looks, maybe 17th or 18th century. But it brings us back onto the Southern Upland Way, which actually crosses the bridge if you're heading west. We're going to go and follow the eastbound back to Gala. And if I remember rightly, we've got a really nice stiff climb up this hill just behind the houses here. It's maybe 4 or 5 years now since I last walked up this hill, and I was fully laden for the Southern Upland Way. Roasting hot day, I'd come right all the way from Innerleithen that morning heading for Melrose, and this hill was a killer. I'll just flip round and let you see. So it dropped down the hill opposite there. You can't see them, but that's where the Southern Upland Way ended up, sort of right at the top of that hill at the place called the Three Brethren, which are three cairns marking the edge of three estates. I think it was landowners that didn't want to outdo each other. I'll pop a bit of information about them up on screen as well. But yeah, this was a real drag, and there's still quite a way to go sort of up to the cairn at the top of the hill, just hidden behind the trees there. Yeah, it took me a bit of time to get up this hill, I can tell you. It's a bit of a haul up this hill, just as I remember it. But the east side of the Southern Upland Way is just a fantastic trail from Moffat onwards. Probably up there is one of the best trails I've done in Scotland. The west side of it, well, it's good, but you're walking through heck of a lot of forestry. This side of the country is a lot more open, but there's not many folk that use the trail. I think when I did it, it was over maybe 17 or 18 days, and I think apart from the odd dog walker, I met possibly maximum about 10 folk walking the trail. But yeah, fabulous trail. And you can see, even just here, how it takes to the high ground. I think I'll maybe, once I've completed the John Muir Way, redo it east to west in sections. Oh, we're getting the full-on Southern Upland Way experience at the moment. Driving rain into the face, blowing a hoolie. Doesn't get much better than this. I think that must be Hoyk in the distance. Need to look at the map and see where it is, but we're nearly up on top of the hill proper. There we are, so once we get on top of that, we should be able to look down into Gala. As we approach the cairn, we get some great views over the hills that we've been walking on the other side of Gala. You can just see the golf course in the middle there, and I think was it Dry Hope Hill, the very first walk that we did from Gala. I can't remember off the top of my head what that was called. I swear my memory's going. But this should be a fabulous view as we get up to the cairn. Oh. This is just great walking. It's a nice grassy path here. Open country, great views. Just absolutely the best of what the Borders is all about. And a lot of the east side of the Southern Upland Way is exactly like this. And from St Mary's Loch, Ettrick Valley, the Captain's Road. There, if I just come round to the right, you've got the Eildons, just that Borders landmark. The Minch Moor from Tracare to the Three Brethren, it's all fabulous. So I was nearly back at the town boundary and the woodland just outside Gala. So the Southern Upland Way used to go right round this hill when it was first opened, but relatively recently, well I say recently, probably the last 10 years or so, rerouted to actually go into Gala, or at least touch Gala town centre. I think just to make it a bit easier for walkers to get services, and probably actually to encourage walkers to go in and use the facilities in the town. It's nothing like watching someone struggle getting over a step stile. So we're coming to the end of our flirtation with the Southern Upland Way, and that heads off to Melrose, off to the right here, and we are going to head straight into Gala Town Centre. I've got to say, I'm kind of sorry to say goodbye to it, because I do enjoy walking sections of the Southern Upland Way. Well, that brings us to the end of another absolutely fantastic walk from this little book, Border Station Walks. If you're enjoying this series of walks, please give us a thumbs up, leave a comment below, or even subscribe to the channel. Very much appreciated. And I'll leave a link, as usual, for the website for the book below. Thanks for watching, and hopefully see you in the next one. Bye for now.